Welcome back to our exploration of figurative language. Today we're going to talk about two types of figurative language. We're going to talk about hyperbole and alliteration. So take a second and practice. Those are weird words. Practice saying them. Hyperbole and alliteration. So what are hyperbole and alliteration, and where can I find them? Well, hyperbole is an over-the-top exaggeration. I'm going to box that word in. And when we're saying over-the-top exaggeration, you might be thinking, well, wait, that sounds a lot like extreme or absolute language. And you would be totally right. Extreme or helps if I spell it right. Extreme or absolute language. So if you're thinking about signposts, that extreme or absolute language is the same thing as hyperbole. It's when you're being dramatic or over the top and you're exaggerating. So let's look at a couple examples. So down here I have my mom always grounds me. Your mom doesn't always ground you. You're not grounded every single day, but sometimes it might feel like that. So in this sentence, somebody is exaggerating. They're using hyperbole to show you how they feel. They feel like they're always grounded. Let's look at the next one. I am so hungry, I could eat 20 pizzas by myself. Again, it's an exaggeration. It's that extreme or absolute language. No one is going to eat 20 pizzas by themselves. You're being hyperbolic. You're using hyperbole. But the author is trying to show how very hungry they are, and maybe also a little bit silly. Let's look at this last one. Tyler is so popular that everyone thinks he's the coolest kid who ever lived. The coolest kid who ever lived. That's pretty over the top. There have been a lot of kids. So it's hyperbole to say that anyone is the coolest kid that ever lived. You're being over the top. That's very extreme language. All of these extreme languages or these exaggerations are examples of hyperbole. The second thing we're going to look at today is alliteration. Oops, not purple, let's do green. Alliteration. Alliteration is when a letter sound gets repeated over and over in a sentence for effect, meaning the same sound happens in multiple different words. Let's look at some examples. So here I have, wordlessly watching, he waits by the window. Do you see how the sentence is full of W words? That W sound gets repeated. Wordlessly watching, he waits by the window. And I actually borrowed this one from a famous song by Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. So if that sounds familiar, maybe you've heard your parents play it on the oldies station. Let's look at another one with a different letter. My mom is making marshmallow treats. My mom is making marshmallow treats. And honestly, that M sound makes me think of yummy things. That repeating that M sound makes the whole thing sound extra yummy. And then down here, I've got, sometimes I sing softly. Do you hear that S sound being repeated? That's what alliteration is. When you repeat the same sound multiple times in a sentence, it just makes it sound interesting. It makes it sound important. Authors use this when they really want to draw your attention to something and show that it's important. Let's look at some examples in songs and see if we can figure out, first of all, can we find these types of figurative language? And then also ask ourselves, why is the songwriter using this? What are they hoping to accomplish?
'Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. So take a look what you've done. 'Cause baby, now we got.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
Watching you stand up. Of the water long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls.